What is up, my badass aliens out there on the internet, and welcome to this Libra Lunar Eclipse video. Oh my god, this eclipse season is freaking insane, okay? So buckle up. I'm sure you've been hearing about it elsewhere, but buckle up because this eclipse season is coming with some really, 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 really big changes for many, many people, okay? Many people's lives will not be the same. This eclipse season is really kind of bringing together like a lot of things that happened back in October of 2023. It's also tying together things from years even before that. And so this eclipse season is a really big freaking deal, okay? Basically, that's what you need to know. It's a really big freaking deal. And we're gonna talk about what it means and why it's a big deal and what you can expect to see, what's coming, all of that jazz. So kick back, relax, and get comfy, and let's get into it. Okay, so as always, starting out with what the fuck is a lunar eclipse? A lunar eclipse is a full moon that is very, very close to the nodal axis. Okay, the nodal axis is basically where we have fated karmic events. It is a very karmic place in the sky. The nodes of the moon really show us where we have past karma, past things, past cycles that is really holding us back in life, And the north node, the opposite of the south node, shows us where we are headed, lessons that we are, our soul is yearning to learn in this life or at this time, right? So this Libra lunar eclipse, this Libra full moon, is very, very close to the south node. So this is a lot of endings, a lot of full circle moment, a lot of past stuff coming up, a lot of karmic stuff coming up, things that have maybe plagued us for a long time, things that maybe we've been either dealing with since last year around October or even years before that, right? So this lunar eclipse in particular is in the sign of Libra. So this is gonna show us a lot about what these karmic endings, these karmic cycles, these karmic situations that are coming up are going to be about. And the sign of Libra, which, hello, I'm a Libra sun here. The sign of Libra deals very much with keeping the peace. It deals with balance, it deals with relationships, it can deal with people pleasing and negotiations and finding the middle ground and really how do we personally interact with others? Like the balance between self and other, and that's so much of what this eclipse is about. Like, how do you interact with the world? How do you interact with other people? What is the balance between putting yourself versus putting other people first, right? What is the balance between the two? What is the relationship with yourself, right? Like, what is your own internal relationship with yourself like? What does that, you know, what is that like? What is your own internal dialogue with yourself? That can be a lot of what comes up during this eclipse, although we can see a lot of situations involving other people, relationships, agreements, negotiations, you know, things ending with all of these things, right? And so this Libra lunar eclipse, what I've been noticing a lot for a lot of people is it's very much about where you are in terms of the relationship with yourself. Because wherever you are in terms of with the relationship with yourself is going to be mirrored to you externally as well. So if you're seeing a lot of things in people around you, where is that mirroring what's going on within you? If you are seeing a pattern with the people in your life, where is that mirroring what's going on within you, right? If you're not seeing certain things in your life, where is that mirroring something that's going on within you? Libra is a sign about mirroring. It's a sign about opposites. It's a sign about balance, right? And the moon is also about mirroring. It's reflective. It reflects the sun's light. Right? So this is a time where we can really see our external, you know, situations, people, relationships being mirrored in terms of what's going on within us. So this Libra lunar eclipse is very much breaking karmic ties to do with the relationship with ourselves and our relationship with others. And those can be any types of relationship. You guys, like it depends on where this is happening for you and where you have, you know, Venus in your chart and like all of that. But like this can be really any kind of relationship. It can be the relationship with your family, relationship with siblings, relationship with friends, relationship with self, relationship with, you know, your partner, your significant other. So it really just depends on, you know, where this is happening in your chart and how this is showing up in your life. But this is so much about finding peace within and finding peace without. What is aligned with us and where are we in alignment, like where are we not in alignment with who we are and where are we not in alignment with the people in our lives? And getting very honest about that, because Libra does have this you know, quality, this energy of truth and honesty and coming to terms with what is true and honest and integrity and right for you. This Libra lunar eclipse could also be bringing up some really big decisions to kind of cut things off that were once maybe aligned, but no longer. Cut things off that were once really like keeping the peace and keeping the balance, but no longer, right? So it's really showing us and reflecting to us a peak point, a peak moment, a peak change to do with relationships in our lives and to do with our relationship internally with ourselves, okay? So that's the big thing here. Now, the other thing about this is that because this eclipse season is going to be very much based around Chiron, the asteroid of Chiron, even though this particular eclipse is not completely opposing Chiron, although it does just, you know, hours later after it's full, but the next eclipse is going to be completely conjunct Chiron. And so Chiron is very much involved in this eclipse season. And so what that tells me is that there's a lot of different patterns coming up to do with where we doubt ourselves. And this is where the internal relationship really comes in our lives. Where are we doubting ourselves? And therefore, that somehow being mirrored back to us in external situations from other people, from other relationships. Where are we holding our own selves back? Where are we our own worst enemy? Where are we divided and not peaceful, not keeping the peace within ourselves? Because the more that we try to please others, the more distance we create, the more conflict we create in self. And that is so much what this eclipse is about. The more you try to keep the peace with others, the more conflict you create inside of yourself. And so at some point, we have to rebalance things in our lives. We have to come back to what is true, real, right for us, what feels aligned for us. With the North Node being in Aries, you know, we are moving to the direction of learning to confront things in our lives, learning to face things in our lives, learning to be brave, learning to worry more about the self and the individual, and release people-pleasing tendencies in our lives, release these, you know, needs for everybody else to be peaceful while we are in conflict because we are not being true to ourselves. We are not leading ourselves in a way that is real, true, and in integrity and in alignment for who we are. So the ruler of this lunar eclipse is Venus, because Venus is the ruler of Libra. So Venus is in the sign of Pisces, pretty much just finishing its conjunction with Saturn. So this tells me that this Libra lunar eclipse does have an emotional element to it. It is going to be about letting things go, accepting the different parts and sides of who we are, and accepting the different sides of ourselves, accepting us for who we are, letting things go that no longer align with us, and letting things go that don't align with us in terms of our relationships and in terms of the things that are moving and going on outside of us with other people, right? So this is gonna be very much about coming back into inner harmony with self and other, right? So you're gonna be noticing a lot of different things coming up in terms of relationships, your relationships, and your relationship with yourself. Because if the relationship with ourself is not stable, that's going to leak into our relationship with other people. If we are always feeling insecure, if we're always feeling down about who we are and down about, you know, confused about what we want and not making decisive decisions, not taking decisive action on the things that we truly desire and what feel right for who we are, then we're going to feel confused. Our relationships are going to get confused. We're going to get confused about what we want in relationships because we're not in alignment with who we are. We're not in our own truth. We're not in our own sovereignty. And so that is so much of what this lunar eclipse in Libra is all about. So with that being said, there's so much more to come in the next 2 weeks with this Aries solar eclipse coming, and I'm going to be doing a video on that, so be on the lookout. That's like the really, really big daddy eclipse of this eclipse season. It's definitely going to be a new beginning. So over the next 2 weeks, you're going to see kind of a realignment, a rebalancing in your life of what is true for you, who you are, what you want, where you're going in life, you know, the decisions that you need to make that are right for you, and not thinking too much about what is right for everybody. That is definitely a part of it. But a lot of the times when I find that when we do what's right for us, it somehow ends up being right for everybody else, when we're honest and true about who we are and what we desire and what we want and how we are feeling or doing in this moment, it ends up playing out great for everybody, because then they can see the truth of who we are. They can know where we're at. Therefore, they can make their own informed decision from that place about what they want and what's right for them, right? And so when we are being honest about who we are, it's right for everybody. It's a win-win situation. Yeah, it may hurt sometimes, or yeah, it may be uncomfortable sometimes, but in the end, if we are being true to who we are, everything works out in the end for everyone involved, because we know that we stuck to our truth. We know that we did what was right for us, and we know that we were in our truth and in alignment with our truth the whole time. So that is what I have to say about this Libra lunar eclipse. We're going to go ahead and get to what this means for your rising sign. So you definitely are going to want to watch your rising sign for this. That's what's going to resonate most. And let's get into it. All right, starting with you, Libra rising, since this eclipse is happening in your first house. So we're going to start with you. So this lunar eclipse is happening in your first house of self-identity, who you are, who you know yourself to be, what is real and true for you right now, what truth needs to come to the surface here, what decisions need to be faced here, what reflections are you seeing outside of yourself that are leading you back to who you are, what sides of yourself are not in alignment, what sides of yourself are in battle that need to be harmonized, that need to be, you know, brought together, embraced, right? So this is really a karmic time of you seeing maybe different parts of yourself that are no longer in alignment with who you are, or different parts and sides of yourself that you don't quite agree with, or that are not agreeing within you. And so this is really about coming back to yourself and learning how to face these things within yourself and within your relationships with others. How much of yourself is influenced by the people around you? How much of your identity is, you know, being reflected back to you by the relationships in your life? How much of you are you being? Are you being in your truth? Or have you allowed yourself to kind of get put on the background? Have you allowed yourself to play smaller, so to say, to appease others around you? Have you became something that you're not, right? Out of insecurity or out of self-doubt or, you know, things like that. Like, how much in alignment are you with your truth? How in your truth are you? And so this is really about coming back to your truth and coming back to a peaceful relationship with yourself and shedding old behaviors, old parts of yourself, old things that are no longer in balance with who you are anymore and who you know yourself to be, how you want to show yourself in the world, right? And so that's so much what this particular lunar eclipse is about. This is a very karmic time bringing you back to yourself, back to your sense of self, back to your identity. So let me know down below how you are feeling this eclipse, if any of that resonates, what you are noticing come up. You know, you could also see some things of like health, body, routines, spiritual practices, habits, subconscious habits really coming up here as well with Venus in your sixth. Maybe something to do with a job, work, or project as well could be coming up with this eclipse. So let me know how that's happening for you down below. And if you would like to book a reading, I do have readings open right now. They are getting booked up pretty quickly though for like the next month. So I do still have some openings left, and they are on sale right now for this eclipse season. So if you're interested, definitely see the description below. Scorpio risings, this eclipse for you is happening in your 12th house. So this is definitely all about the subconscious behind the scenes stuff, right? Maybe some hidden stuff gets revealed that you weren't totally aware of. Maybe some endings are happening right now that to really clean out your life and bring your subconscious world back into balance. Maybe there are some relationship stuff, you know, relationship themes coming up where things were hidden or behind the scenes. You know, the 12th house can deal with hidden enemies. So it's like things could be appearing about other people that you weren't quite aware of. You know, relationships that, you know, maybe you thought you had with other people could be coming up that, you know, maybe weren't what you thought they were. This is really a karmic clearing out of relationships for you, but also a very, like, you know, intense look at the relationship with yourself and with your own subconscious, with the ways in which you maybe even work against yourself and aren't always aware of it, right? Self-sabotaging behaviors, patterns, cycles. This is going to be the really, really big topic of this eclipse for you if you're Scorpio rising. You could also notice themes of, you know, love, romance, dating, relationships, children, things like that definitely coming up here with Venus being in your fifth house. Like maybe you were kind of seeing someone and you find something out about them, or they're not exactly who you thought they were, or you've been kind of partaking in certain, you know, behaviors in terms of dating and relationships that are very self-sabotaging, that are really kind of bringing up, you know, coming to your attention here so they can kind of bring an end to some of these patterns, some of these cycles that you keep finding yourself in terms of relationships, dating, you know, things like that. This could also just be like, if everything's good in your relationships, this could also just be habits, things clearing out, your relationship with yourself, your relationship with love, your relationship with intimacy, your relationship with fun, you know, things like that could be coming up around this time if you're a Scorpio rising. So let me know down below what you are noticing if you're a Scorpio rising, how that all relates to you. And then also, I have my readings are on sale right now for eclipse season. So definitely see the description below if you are interested in booking a reading right now. Sagittarius risings, this eclipse for you is happening in your 11th house of friends, other people, networking, acquaintances, groups of people. So, you know, putting yourself out there, being seen, marketing, these types of things are really coming up around this time if you're a Sagittarius rising. So this could be you kind of trying to find, you know, different connections, whether that be online, an audience, or whether that be in real life with friendships. Either way, there is something being highlighted here with this eclipse that's really big, that's really showing you like, hey, there may be certain connections, negotiations, contracts, agreements, relationships with other people that you once had that are now coming to an end, or that you're now, that are now reaching their full potential in some way, right? This could somehow tie in with your private life, with your home and family life, you know, something along those lines. You could be, you know, there could be something vulnerable, emotional, private kind of going on that somehow intersects with your social life or your status in terms of a group of friends or your status in terms of a group of people. So something like that could be coming up, but it's definitely, definitely, definitely about your relationships, connections, friendships, acquaintances, you know, all of that, your connections in your life. And you could be kind of seeing where some of those things, some of those behaviors, some of those relationships may be somewhat karmic, or maybe you repeating old cycles that are now being shown to you, right? There could also be a lot of people maybe coming back around from the past. You know, you could be noticing a lot of patterns with this area of your life because it's trying to teach you something, it's trying to show you something, or at least something is coming to fruition here with this. So definitely let me know down below if you're Sag rising, how you're seeing this play out. I would really love to hear your feedback down in the comments. And then also, I do have a sale right now going on my readings for eclipse season. So if you would like to book, definitely see the description below. Alrighty, Capricorn risings, this lunar eclipse is happening in the sign of Libra in your 10th house of your career, your status, your public image, your long-term goals, your legacy. This is a big deal. This is the part of your chart where you put yourself out there. You're known in the world, you're visible. You know, this is your career, your long-term goals, the things that you're working towards in your life, your status, your public reputation, things like this. So a lot of these topics could be coming up right now. The moon here in Libra, and this lunar eclipse, and it being a south node lunar eclipse, this really tells me that you could be kind of giving up maybe an old role, an old reputation, an old, you know, connection, career-related connection or relationship, you know, or connection with a certain career, with a certain big long-term goal that you once had, or completing one. At the very least, there could be one just coming to fruition here. There's some kind of closure here, though, happening, it feels like, for you if you're Capricorn rising, where you are really kind of rethinking, rebalancing what you want to be known as, what you want to be known for, what you're here to do, your place in the world, your reputation, your status, you know, how you want to be seen in terms of your career, in terms of your goals, in terms of your legacy. And, you know, with that being said, this is also so much about you kind of getting very, very clear on what your truth is and how that truth relates to your life and where you're going and your destiny. This is also you getting very clear on your self-expression, how you want to express yourself, with Venus ruling this lunar eclipse being in your third house, your environment and how that is influencing you, your creative skill sets and how that is playing into this, right? So these are all things that you could also be like noticing coming up with this lunar eclipse. So let me know if you're Capricorn rising down below, how this is playing out for you and what you are noticing here with this eclipse coming up. I'd really love to hear how this is affecting you and what you're noticing going on in your life. Also, I do have a sale on my readings right now that won't be lasting much longer for this eclipse season. So if you are interested, definitely see the description below. So for Aquarius risings, this lunar eclipse is happening in your 9th house, which is really like the higher mind, right? This is really very much where you connect with your belief systems, with your views on life, with what you believe about the world, with what you believe about life in general, why we are here, what we're doing here, where you find meaning and purpose in your experience in life. And so this is a time where you could be letting go of a lot of old beliefs in terms of, or a lot of old morals, values, virtues that you once had that, you know, you used to try to balance out. This could even be letting go of maybe old political beliefs for some of you, or really kind of seeing a culmination or a closure happening with these things in some way. There could be some shift going on here where you're noticing maybe certain toxic cycles or toxic patterns to do with how you've been viewing things in the world. Maybe you've been noticing that they're one, you've been kind of viewing them from a one-sided way, or maybe you've been noticing you've been allowing other people to influence your beliefs, your outlooks, the way that you see things, what you want to do with your life, where you get inspiration from, where you, you know, want to maybe go back to school, your educational pursuits. Maybe you've been allowing certain things to influence your thinking in this way. And so this time period and this eclipse time period is very much about releasing these old big worldly, some of these old big karmic worldly beliefs that have been keeping you stuck or holding you back in your life and keeping you from being able to think individually, keeping you from being able to do what you want in your daily life because you have these big higher belief systems in this relationship with these higher belief systems, or, you know, these certain, you know, morals or whatever that have been holding you back, you know, in your life. This could be even your religious views, your political views, your spiritual views, whatever it is. You know, there's something here where you're like kind of maybe reconciling something or seeing the other side of something potentially that, you know, has, you know, been holding you back for potentially a while in your life, and is kind of coming to this full circle moment of you realizing like, I can't keep letting these big overarching ideas about how the world works or things that I've been attached to before continue to hold me back in my daily life and hold me back from taking action on the things that I individually want in my daily life, right? Like you can't carry the world on your shoulders. You can't carry other people's feuds, you know, all over the world on your shoulders. You're just one freaking person, right? And so that's like really big here. You could definitely be noticing a rebalancing in terms of you coming into harmony within yourself and your relationship with your, you know, big worldly ideas and beliefs. So that's what I see happening for you, Aquarius. Also, if you are interested, my readings right now are on sale for eclipse season. So let me know if, well, don't let me know. Let me know how this resonated. But if you are interested in booking a reading, definitely click the link in my bio to learn more about how you can do that right now. Okay, anyway, got tongue-tied there. Moving on to Pisces rising. So for Pisces risings, this lunar eclipse is happening. I forgot what I was talking about for a second. It is happening in your eighth house. And so this is a very karmic fated lunar eclipse that is very much about your relationships to your finances and your financial relationships. So anybody that you share resources or finances with, anyone you get finances from, anyone you give finances to, the give and take in your financial situation is really being highlighted here. And it could be showing you where maybe your financial decisions, your financial, you know, situation has maybe been being influenced by other people. So these are karmic debts that could be coming up, karmic cycles, patterns that could be coming up where you are really noticing that maybe it's time to end certain agreements, certain financial agreements, certain financial negotiations, you know, whatever that you've been having in your life. Maybe it's time to go your own way in terms of your finances. Maybe it's time to, you know, let go of old contracts, old agreements in terms of financial situations. Or just, I mean, it doesn't have to necessarily be financial. It could really be, you know, anything that you really share with another person or just relationships in general. This could be a time where you are releasing certain relationships, agreements, etc. in your life that no longer suit you or bring value to you, right? Because the ruler of this eclipse is in your sign right now, Venus. So you are likely feeling this eclipse a lot, maybe even more than most of the other signs, because of the ruler being in your sign right now and her being exalted. So I do think that this is actually beneficial for you. This eclipse is beneficial for you. This eclipse is bringing some good vibes your way, basically, as a Pisces rising. And it is showing you your own worth, your own value, and how maybe you don't need to depend on or rely on other people in certain situations anymore. That's really what I see coming up for you if you're Pisces rising. You don't need to be influenced by outside circumstances or situations financially, and you can actually maybe put an end to some of these things, make decisions, get honest about where you're at and what you want here, right? So let me know if you're a Pisces rising, how that is resonating down below, because I'd be very interested to hear it. And then also, if you are interested, I do have a sale going on my readings right now for eclipse season. So if you are interested, definitely see the link down below in my description to book one of those. It won't be lasting much longer. So Aries risings. So for Aries risings, this lunar eclipse is happening in your seventh house. So this is very, 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 very much about relationships for you. If you are an Aries rising, I definitely see you releasing a lot of old karmic stuff in terms of relationships. You are learning to let go. You are learning to forgive. You are learning to, release. You are learning to believe in something and trust in something bigger than yourself, because the ruler of this eclipse for you is in your 12th house. And this full moon eclipse itself is happening in your seventh house of relationships. This is a lot of purging, releasing, purifying, forgiving, healing in terms of relationships for you if you are an Aries rising. So this is really showing you as well where certain relationships in your life and certain relationship dynamics and certain relationship patterns are mirroring to you who you are, right? They're mirroring different things to you. They're reflecting different things back to yourself. So this is a time where you could be seeing yourself in a new light, where you could be seeing, you know, different sides of certain relationships in your life, especially significant relationships in your life, like your partner, your marriage partner, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever. But this is definitely a time where you are, you know, doing a lot of releasing, forgiving, healing in terms of relationships. And this is a very karmic time, so there could be endings for some of you. You kind of really finding that it is maybe in your truth and in alignment for you to end certain situations, end certain relationships, release certain agreements, contracts, etc. For others of you, this could just be, you know, you really coming to this like full circle moment and really realizing certain patterns in your relationships that you are releasing, certain subconscious, you know, things going on that you're releasing, forgiving, letting go of, that can help your relationship thrive even more. So that is what I'm seeing for you if you are an Aries rising. Definitely let me know down below if that is resonating for you. If you are seeing these things come up, I'd really, really love to hear what's going on with you if you're an Aries rising. And if you need to book a reading, I got you. My readings are on sale right now for eclipse season. Definitely see the link below. That won't last for long. Alrighty, we have Taurus risings. This lunar eclipse for you is happening in your sixth house of work, health, daily routines, your daily tasks, your daily projects, you know, things like this. So with this full moon lunar eclipse happening here, this is a very big karmic deal. And what that really means is that you are probably noticing a lot coming up around this time to do with releasing habits, patterns, health-related habits, health-related patterns, work-related habits, work-related patterns, to do with, you know, anything that feels out of balance, to do with your relationships as well, relationships that you may have with coworkers, the relationship you have with your body, the relationship you have with health, the relationship you have with your work and the kind of work that you do, any kind of karmic jumbled up stuff here that is no longer good for you, right? Any like habits and patterns that are affecting your physical, tangible life and the relationships you have with your life or in your life are going to be shown here and highlighted here. So this is a time of you really letting go of a lot of this and this being really highlighted for you. Where do you have certain patterns, certain relationships, certain cycles, habits, you know, that are affecting your day-to-day life? And this could also be bringing in this influence of like friends and your social life and, you know, certain dreams that you have and where maybe things that are out of balance in your day-to-day life are really holding you back from those things, right? Or where maybe you've been kind of influenced by other people and that's been going into your habits, health, and work, right? And so this is a situation, you know, this is these are the topics that are really being highlighted for you at the time of this eclipse. So definitely pay attention to these and let me know down below what you are noticing come up. If you're a Taurus rising, I'd really be interested to know how this is affecting you. And then also, if you need a reading right now, I got you. My readings are on sale for eclipse season. Go hit the link below. They won't last for long. And we are going to move on to Gemini. So for Gemini risings, this eclipse for you is happening in your fifth house. So fun stuff, dating, fun, romance, you know, all of the things that, you know, make your heart come alive, the things that feel good, that are beautiful, that are nice, and, you know, that have a aesthetic kind of vibe, you know. So these are the topics that you're really noticing come up at this time. You know, there's a lot of releasing that you could do if you're a Gemini rising right now with like writing, poetry, art, you know, things like that. There's a lot of releasing that you could do, a lot of like tapping into to things, karmic things that need to be let go of that you could do at this time. Also, this could be bringing up a lot of your Gemini rising, certain karmic patterns and cycles that you have in terms of dating and, you know, your ideas on relationships, your ideas on, you know, dating and romance and love and all of that. Like a lot of that could be coming up at this time. It could be highlighting, you know, some dating situations in your life that could be either coming to an end, or you could definitely just be seeing like there are certain karmic patterns here or cycles here that you need to release. You're really figuring out like what you want and where you've maybe allowed what you actually want, like, and desire to be influenced by other people, right? And this really somehow can be playing a role in your career as well, in your outlook on life, where you're going in life, your status, your long-term goals, you know, your visibility, right? Like, this is really so much about your goals and career as well, too, and your you know, reputation. So that could be really playing a part in this too. If you're a Gemini rising, you could be really seeing where, you know, you have been kind of compromising too much or people pleasing too much of what you want or in your dating life. And somehow that is being shown to you and potentially even affecting your career and long-term goals. So let me know if you're Gemini rising, if that relates and what you are noticing come up at this time. I'd really love to hear your feedback and how you're noticing this come up. And I know that you like to have conversations as a Gemini rising. So let me know down below all the tea and what's going on. And then also if you are wanting to book a reading at this time, I do have readings on sale for this eclipse season. They won't last for long and they will sell out quick. So definitely see the link below if you're interested. So, okay, moving on to Cancer rising. So for Cancer risings, this lunar eclipse is happening in your fourth house of home, family, your private life, your personal life, everything going on behind closed doors. What does your relationship look like with your family members, with your home life, you know, with your parents, you know, with the ones that you live with, you know, all of that, like this is really, really coming up. I'm still getting over a cold, so just excuse me, but this is really coming up at this time. So you're really looking at like, okay, where do my relationship patterns, you know, get fueled from my family members? Where have I allowed maybe other people's opinions in my family or in my life growing up to really affect me? And where does, you know, where is all of these different patterns in my heritage and my lineage and my ancestry? How does this all connect to you and your life right now? That's really what's coming up. It's like there's a lot coming up in terms of your relationships with your family, with your ancestry, with your home life, with where you live, with where you're from, your childhood, like all of that. This lunar eclipse is really purging old karmic cycles to do with how you relate with your family. Okay, so that's going to be really huge. And this somehow is tying into your beliefs and your inspiration on where you find purpose and meaning in the world as well. Maybe traveling, maybe you've allowed like your family and your family's ideas and their opinions to maybe hold you back from things that you're really passionate about or inspired about or that you want to do or the beliefs that you want to have. Maybe you've allowed their beliefs to affect you and affect what you're doing and affect what you want. So let me know down below if you're a Cancer rising, how you are seeing these themes come up in your life. I'd really love to hear your feedback. And if you would like a reading during this time, I do have my readings on sale for a short amount of time. Right now for eclipse season, they will sell out fast. So if you're interested, you can book in the link below. So alrighty, moving on to my fellow Leo rising. So let's freaking do it. Okay, let's freaking do it. So this Libra eclipse for us is in our third house. So this is really bringing up our relationship with our siblings, our relationships with cousins, neighbors, you know, extended family, right? Extended family. So we could definitely be noticing a lot of karmic stuff coming up here that maybe has been going on for like the last 6 months or even longer for some people, that could really be coming to a head here or coming to a close. There could even be like, you know, legalities involved, contracts, agreements, negotiations, or just relationships that are really coming to a head in terms of, you know, those topics in our lives. What we're also likely noticing is how influenced we are by those things and how influenced we are by our environment, right? How our environment is getting into our heads or influencing us, how influenced we are by our day-to-day thinking, our day-to-day minds, our day-to-day relationships and interactions with other people, and how that can sometimes throw us off track and keep us out of our bigger picture way of thinking and what we really want to do and our goals in the world, right? And so this is really coming up right now to really show us where we have kind of small-minded thinking versus where we have kind of bigger picture thinking, right? And where it's time to maybe release old negative mindsets in our relationship to our mindset and how we usually think on a day-to-day basis and how that ends up maybe being kind of karmic or pulling us into traps, patterns, cycles, etc., right? So this is a very big for like mindset, our environment, community, our family, extended family, you know, all of these different topics could really, really be coming up right now. This is a great time to kind of maybe express your truth, express yourself more, make, you know, a different decision than what you've been making, you know, do something different than what you've been doing, kind of following your truth, following your voice, allowing your voice, like setting your voice free in some way and being honest about where you're at and what is actually going on with you so you can come back into balance with yourself instead of trying to appease or please everybody else or other people in your environment, in your life, right? So this is gonna be really, really big for that. Somehow finances and, you know, finances, emotions, the occult, spiritual practices, things like this could somehow be tying in with what's happening right now as Venus is the ruler of this eclipse and she is in our eighth house exalted. So there could be things that we are releasing and that are coming back into balance in our lives at this time. I don't believe this is necessarily like a negative thing for us. I think that things are kind of working themselves out. Things are kind of balancing themselves out. We just need to have the belief and have the trust to release what is not true for who we are, right? And that's like, that's the big thing here, right? So if you're a fellow Leo rising, let me know if this is resonating with you. I know I've seen a lot of these things in my life just over like the last week. So I would love to know what you're seeing in your life and how, if this is resonating with you too and how it is and what you are seeing in your life. I'd love to find that out. And also if you need a reading right now, I got you. I have a limited time sale on my personal chart readings right now that you can book below. They will sell out quick. So definitely get in there if you're interested. So, alrighty, Leo, thank you. We're gonna move on. Last but not least, Virgo rising. So for Virgo risings, this lunar eclipse is happening in your second house of values, your own personal finances, your own personal resources, the things that you own and have to yourself, the things that make you feel secure, safe, and stable, and the things that, you know, you really prioritize and value in your life and your relationship with these things. So this is a time where you could definitely be letting go or finally ending some kind of karmic contract or agreement in your life to do with your finances, to do with someone else and your finances, to do with, you know, where you've allowed yourself to be influenced financially in your life or influenced away from certain values that you have, you know, where you've maybe compromised too much or come in somehow, you know, come out of balance with your values, virtues, with your priorities, finances, etc., right? So this is a time where you could be really noticing that, where you could be really getting back to the truth of what is aligned for you in this area of life and what feels the most balanced for you and not necessarily in your relationship to these things instead of worrying about what other people want and all of that. This is really big. This is really big. And this definitely pulls in your relationships, maybe with a significant other, a spouse, an ex-spouse, you know, like something like that. An ex, you know, partner, whatever, an ex-business partner or a current business partner, because Venus is in your seventh house of relationships. So this really does tell me this is tying in relationships with you, where things are coming to an end financially in a relationship situation, or coming to an end in terms of your priorities, your values, or just you rebalancing something, you know, you coming back into your truth, into alignment, into harmony with your own values, virtues, and priorities, and somehow that leading to your relationships in some way. So that's what I'm seeing for you, Virgo. Let me know down below if that resonated and what you are noticing coming up at this time. I'd really, really be curious to know. And if you need a reading right now, my readings are on sale for a very short amount of time. You can click the link below and get in there. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next one. Happy lunar eclipse. Bye.